Good morning. Good morning. Can you hear me? Yes. Okay. All right. Good. Okay. Today, I thought of using a PowerPoint presentation to deliver the lecture that was prepared by one senior lecturer, namely Dr. Udayangani Thalgaspitiya, based on my book, title of which is Human Resource Management Personnel, Employee Movements. In Sinhala, we call Sevadayaka Chalan, Sevadayaka Chalan. Learning outcomes. Okay, so these are the learning outcomes. So employee movements, identify types of employee movements. Mainly there are three types of employee movements you are supposed to learn. First one is promotions, usasvim or usaskirim, then transfers, maruvim, even the marukirim, and layoff, navatali, navata, Lima, layoff, right. Types of employee movements. So these three things. Today, I hope within this limited time, I will be able to discuss the relevant aspects. Right. What is a promotion? Usasvima kiyanne kumakda? The promotion is the appointment of an employee who is currently working in the organization to a job that is higher or greater than the job being performed by him or her. Okay, danata karunu labana rakiyawata wada wedi ihala rakiyawa. Sevadayakayek patkirima tama usasvima kiyala kiyanne. So it is an advancement of an employee to a better job. Vada hunda rakiyawa. Usaskiri. Vada hunda rasiya hunda rakiyawakata yela. It is an advancement of an employee to a better job. Then what do you mean by a better job? Hunda rakiyawa kiyala kiyanne mokak? Better in terms of greater responsibilities. Can very poor Wagakim thin, more prestige, Vedi Varaprasadati, more rank, Nilain Nihela Vedi, better jobs and conditions, Vada Hunda Rakia Pundesi, Niaman thin, greater skills, Vedi Usalata Avashavet, better job title, Vada Hunda Rakia Namya thin, an increased rate of pay or salary, Vedi Vetanya Tibet. So better kill again, greater responsibilities, more prestige, more rank, better terms and conditions, greater skills, better job title, and increased rate of pay or salary. The maya turin, anivaryam tibiyetu lakshana degatin, usasvimagin. There must be two features, essential two features, or two essential features. Or two features which are compass for an movement, for an employee movement to be called as a promotion. Promotion. Can you think of that? two essential features. Out of these, you know, greater responsibilities, more prestige, greater rank, greater job titles and conditions, anivaryam vibhitu lakshana deka thiyena usasima kiyala kiyanne. For an employee movement to be called as a promotion, there must be essentially two conditions. Right, better job title, correct. Wada honda rakkiya namayak thiyena, better job title. Without a better job title, that is not a promotion. For example, assume currently your job is assistant manager, then better title is manager. Currently, if your job title is manager, then better title is senior manager. Senior manager. Then higher salary than the current salary. Yes. So I got a response. That is also correct, right? Higher salary. Then there should be better pay. There should be better title. Otherwise, it is not a promotion. But for some promotions, greater responsibilities, more prestige, more, you know, better job terms and conditions can be or may be associated. The udaharanayak hadiyata the vahanayak labenna puluwan. Dan karana rassawa vahanayak ne. Dan karana rakkiyawata adala vahanayak ne. There's no vehicle for the current job. But for the promoted job, there may be a vehicle. There may be a vehicle. Increase responsibility kiyala thawa response ekak mata labuna. Increase. I got another response from one of the students. Increase responsibility. I really appreciate that response. But increase responsibility ema hema promotion ekkama enne. Increase responsibility. Responsibilities wedi wen nathuwa unath promotion denna puluwan. Therunada? ඒකත් මතක තියා ගන්න ඕනේ. ඒවට කියනවා quasi promotion කියලාත් කියනවා. Quasi. 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 Quasi promotion. ආරූඪ උසස් වීම කියලා කියනවා. ව්‍යාජ්‍ය කියලා අපිට කියන්න බෑ. ආරූඪ උසස්. මොකද ඒක ව්‍යාජ්‍ය වෙන්නේ නැහැනේ. Better title තියෙනවා, better pay තියෙනවා. So then it doesn't become a fake employee promotion. Invalid employee promotion. But it's a valid employee promotion because of better title and better pay. So always then there is no greater responsibility associated with promotion. The udaharanayakata api hitumuko senior lecturer grade 2 indala grade 1 karana. The same responsibilities. You know, so officer grade 2, you know, can be promoted to officer grade 1. With same responsibilities. Of course, for some promotions, definitely there's a greater responsibility. Right, okay. Then these are some definitions from William F. Buick, Professor William F. Buick, from Dr. Graham and Dr. Bennett. From this definition, you know, greater responsibility and different duties from William F. Buick. So then he considers, you know, a promotion must have, I mean, promotion should normally involves greater responsibilities. Samanyen greater responsibilities thiyena. Ema nathi wennat puluwa. Right. Okay, so then especially, you know, it is possible not to have greater responsibility, but normally, yes. So therefore, this definition also acceptable to us. The promotion is a move of an employee to job, right? Okay, these things, you know, in order to save time, I'm not going to discuss all. Right, then why should we give promotions to employees? What is the importance of promotions? Employees increase their productivity because of promotions. Or, you know, if we can tell that, you know, if you increase your productivity within this year, by 25%, you will receive promotions. Then with that hope, employees can increase their productivity. You know, the productivity is a very, very important thing. Without productivity, there's no survival, there's no growth. Employees become more happy and hopeful because of promotions. You know, better title, better rank, better pay. So employees become more happy and hopeful. Balapurthu Sahitha Veli. Get more contribution from younger employees. So younger employees, you know, we can get more contribution by telling that, right, there are promotion opportunities for you. You have to work hard and you have to work smart. Increase your productivity. Increase your attendance. Increase your job, you know, involvement or engagement. To attract suitably qualified applicants for the employment in the organization. Reduce employee absenteeism and employee turnover. The saving yuvak team wage deval usas team deela saving illa streams idu wenakota ewa nathara karanna puluwa ema vela thiyena. You know, there were incidents where, you know, employee decided to resign and then later employee was given a promotion, then decided not to resign. So therefore we can reduce employee turnover. Also employee absenteeism. Yan kiyanna pulwan promotion ekak ganna nan aniwaryen hemadaama enno. Enata maasayakata ek dawasai absent wenna puluwan. Ema condition ekak danna. Okay, in order to get the promotion, it is essential to come to work every day. Or only one absent per month. That type of condition we can meet. And then what will happen? That will reduce employee absentees. More likely. Right. Then types of promotions. Then gudak aya api aya promotions iti bala paruttu nattara. You know, promotions bala paruttu nattara. Okay, and almost all the employees expect promotions. You know, expect promotions. Much coveted. Much, you know, I mean, desires. Promotions. Samanya jeevitha kaale aduwasen ekka promotion ekak laba ganna one sevike ekunama natha wedak ne. Ehema nikan adahas ehema kiyawanak thiyena. You know, it is useless that, you know, if an employee gets retired without getting any promotion. So at least during his or her employment time, a promotion should be gained, should be obtained. Right. Then types of promotions, upgrading, upclassing, same functional field, different functional field. Upgrading, ekeni sreeniya usas karana. Upgrading from one grade to a higher grade. You know, the employee is moved. Example, Mr. Asoka is a clerk, grade 2. And he is promoted to the post of clerk, grade 1. So we have to assume that grade 1, clerk grade 1 is higher than clerk grade 2. In some companies, you know, grade 2 එක වඩා ඉහළයි grade 1 එකට. නමුත් අපි බොහෝ වෙලාවට තියෙන මේ තත්ත්වය, you know, grade 1, normally grade 2, sorry, grade 3, grade 2, grade 1, so likewise. Then up classing. Class එක පන්තිය වැඩි කරනවා. Samanya pantiyak athule thamai grades tiyenne. You know, within one class there can be several grades. It is the movement of the employee from one class to a higher class. An example, Mrs. Chanjani is an administrative officer, class 2, grade 1. In the Sri Lanka administrative service. Now she is promoted as an administrative officer class 1 ඒතොර grade 1 කියලා ගන්න class 1 grade 1 කියලා එකක් තියෙන්න පුළුවන් නැති වෙන්න පුළුවන් it's possible to have class 1 grade 2 class 1 grade 1 අපි විද්‍යාලපති ශ්‍රේණිය ගන්න විද්‍යාලපති ශ්‍රී ලංකා ශ්‍රී ලංකා ප්‍රින්සිපල් සර්ස් there are 3 classes class 3 class 2 class 1 so you know currently assume one principal is in class 3 and that principal can be moved to class 2 or that is an example of this promotion up classing same functional field ekama functional field ek sitha sheshti usas same denna puluwan for example okay what is the example given here right madhusika is a human you know human resource executive human resource executive or hr executive and hr executive n kiyala thiyena o kiyala thiyena hari samanyen mama eka kiyala denna athimita kalin ewa bhavithaya yanawa ewa wenas wenna puluwan hard rule ekak ne samanyen abbreviation ek kiyana na hr kiyala api n kiyala dana human resource kiyala api pronounce karana na a kiyala inda ide eka you know hard rule ekak ne That is also possible. Look at this example. Mr. Piyal has worked as a sales executive in the marketing function. So the marketing department, the marketing field, එක තමයි වැඩ කරේ. Sales executive කෙනෙක් හැටියට Mr. Priyalal is promoted to the post of assistant accounts manager in finance function. Finance function එකට promote කරලා දෙනවා. So different functional field. From one functional field to another one functional field, a promotion can occur. Right now, methods of promoting employees. Usas stream karna krama manavada. Basically, there are two methods. First method is called clause method. Second method is called open method. Alternatively, first method is called management decision by management decision. Second method is by internal advertisement. Kalamanakarana thirnayak man. Saha internal advertisement abhyantara pracharana dannimak mata pracharanima. Kohomanak thirin dan methana me me samanya dan literature wala pawichchi inne by management decision and internal advertisement. Thor wada sudusu close method open method kene mokada dan me yatade unath kalamanakarana thirnayak thama iganna. හරි එනිසා මේ පොත ලියන කාලේ ඒ පවතින existing literature එකේ terms පාවිච්චි කරා අපිට මට ඕන විදිහට මේවා දාන්නත් බෑනේ you know we have to respect the authority we have to respect previous authors we have to respect previous researchers we have to respect you know yes those people who really develop those learning materials by being citizens of developed countries where you know very good hr practices were you know best world recognized organizations were functioning they hima ratawal wala aya thama me waliyala thiyen yunu ratawal wala apita ya apita ona widiyata hima wacana daanna ba honda ne right but anyway so then management decision okay clause method what is this under this method an employee is selected for a promotion on the basis of information already known by the management of the organization Then the decision of promotion is made secretly. And here we have that. That's the important point here. Very important point. The decision of promoting is taken secretly. Usaskiri me tirne ganne rashalis secretly. Here we have close skill again. Avrutakrami. Virudane. Promotion opportunity is not published. Prasiddha karanne. තොට ඉම්ප්ලෝ කළමනාකරුවට ප්‍රධාන කළමනාකරුවට අවශ්‍ය කෙන රහසේ තීරණය කරලා ප්‍රකාශයට පත් කරනවා. Okay, but by internal advertisement or an open method, no. Promotion opportunities will have to be published, will have to be advertised. Then all the relevant people will come to know that there are promotion opportunities. Then they can decide to apply, they can decide not to apply. ඒගොල්ලන් apply කරන්නත් පුළුවන් apply කරන්න නැතුව ඉන්න. ඒක advertise කරලා. ඊට පස්සේ advertise කරලා ඉවරලා applications ආවට පස්සේ ඒ වලින් තමයි තෝරන්නේ. ඒක කියනවා open method කියලා. Right, now tell me which one is better? If you are the relevant manager, which method are you going to use for giving employee promotions? Right, got a response open, right, very good. Why? Three responses I got. Open method, very good. Why? Closed method seems to be biased. Ah, right. Very good. Closed method seems to be biased. Biased wage pena. Habai the open method dolak biased dalate. It is possible to have, you know, prejudices under open method also. Provided, essentially there must be a very good scheme. If not very good, there must be a good scheme for promotion. Whether it is closed method or open method, there must be a good scheme of promotion. Objective good scheme of promotion. Then we will be able to reduce biases. Transparency ke liye kahte hain? Transparency. Transparent. Very good. More transparent. Yes, correct. So they advertise Kerala, it was apply Kerala, applicants latterin torano, yes. We tell openly, you know, there are promotion opportunities. Then under this method, clause method, you know, it is possible to have greater number of grievances. So I will do a separate lecture on grievance handling. Right. So we can reduce, you know, the number of grievances. We can reduce the number of misunderstanding. We can reduce the number of biased, you know, prejudices under open method. So therefore, yes, we can recommend for an organization to use open method. Can open method take a bit of recommend can follow? Closed method take a while. Yes, more appropriate. Right. Then, you know, this closed method can reduce conflict. Oh, conflicts reduce karana pulan, correct, under open method. Then have a vasyaktiana closed method. Because within a very limited time, we can do the promotion. It doesn't take much time, it doesn't take much effort. But on the open method, we have to advertise, we have to get applications, we have to evaluate applications. We have to conduct interviews, and then we have to decide. So therefore, it is expensive. The one among the Kramikunat, Avasithin. That is the nature. Okay. So therefore, I am Hadisi promotion, then no one prior was in the me loss method. When there's a serious need of giving an immediate promotion. And then practically, it is possible to use closed method now. Right. Now, how to give promotions? I mean, methods, then on what basis, on what criteria should we give promotions? The mona nirnayaka matada, that be open method deke ho, closed method deke ho, the mona nirnayaka matada then. Now, we are going to learn those criteria, promotion criteria. Basically, there are two types of criteria which we can use for giving employee promotions. The first one is formal criteria. Under formal criteria, there are two: seniority and merit. Seniority and merit. Yes. Competency or merit. And then informal criteria, the second category: personal influence, political influence, personal liking. Personal influence, political influence, personal liking. And informal criteria, avidhi mandira aikmana ukkilika balapan, personal influence. Example ekathama api to mem right, I am the decision maker, so I am the top executive, so I am the direct, you know, the relevant person who can make the promotions, relevant authority who can make the promotions. I am influenced by my wife, you know, to give a promotion to person Mrs. A. Then that is an example of personal influence. Again, Mrs. A to dindaki na promotion ekak. Kawuda? Spouse, wife. That is personal influence. Then I should decide not to give or give. If I accept that influence, then I will give the promotion to Mrs. A. That is a promotion given based on an informal criterion, that is personal influence. And then political influence. There are so many examples. Political influence. That may be national, that may be in you know, internal. Internal, external. Politics. National, external can national politics. Coming from president, prime minister, you know, ministers, parliamentary members, and other political figures. Internal politics, like an abhyantari in the world. You know, certain superiors, certain bosses, they may influence. Right. Then personal liking can come at the Udgalika Kamathi. Mom may add a Kamathi in the promotion again. Mara Rakamathi in the ad promotion again. You know, I like this person, therefore I give that promotion to that person. I don't like this person, so I don't give that promotion to that person. Examples, personal life, right? The theory, ideal theory of HRM suggests not to use informal criteria. Don't give promotion based on informal criteria because there will be a lot of bad consequences. Bad consequences, anisi pratipaka godak in the book. Okay, right. Then formal criteria. One person, I got to raise the hand, okay. If you want to have a question, you can ask, no problem. If you want to ask a question. Right. Formal criteria. I think informal criteria, mata goda promotion dunne inda tamai, samalata Lankawa me wage thiyena tamai. Ekata ek hetuwa. Lankawa kiyanne ithama honda sundara ratak, ithama wedagath ratak. Namuth, you know, unfortunately, we are having many problems relating to HRM, relating to financial management, relating to operations management. Right. Formal criteria. Matha denne kiyala tamai kiyanne. The theory of HRM suggests to use formal criteria. Seniority and merit. What is seniority? That is the length of time the employee has served for the organization. Seva dayakaya ayathane wenu weda karapu pramana kala pramana seniority. That is based on normally the, you know, that is counted by using the date of joining the organization. Employees date of joining the organization. ආයතනයට සම්බන්ධ වුණු දිනය මත තමයි අපි සීනියොරිටි තීරණය කරන්නේ. අපි හිතමුකෝ for example මෙතන job seniority, department seniority, organization seniority, there are three types of seniority. The job එකේ කොච්චර කාලයක්ද? department ekada villaku vachara kaala organization ekada villaku vachara kaala how many years of working on the job assume job is hr executive then how many years of serving within the hr department that is department senior then how many years for working you know how many years of working for the particular organization concerned that is organization senior okay assume Mr. Pereira joined the organization 15 years ago and then joined as hr executive okay joined as hr executive now he is the director of hr human resources but he was promoted to that post 2 years ago then what is the job seniority what is the job seniority then abhi have me mai then etana seniority gattama compare karannu udgran kipa denek innu e ehemath api comparison perspective ekunu ganna puluwa comparison nathuwa gathe yana udgalan 3 denek karagena kawuda most senior ilangada senior kiyala balata then me example ekak dunnoth ema if I give an example right you know okay 3 people as a b c d there are 3 people a b c d okay a b c there are 3 people වෙලා යනවා ඉතින් මේවා ලියන්න කිව්වොත් වෙලා යනවා පොඩි වෙලාවක් ඉන්න තියෙන නිසා අපි so okay a join the company b join the company 10 years ago c join the company 5 years ago and then the most senior person is a the next one is b the next one is c okay so in that way please try to understand right then competency merit is that's the degree of efficiency and effectiveness of the employee merit a competency kela tapi kiyana knowledge skills aptitude ewa danna puluwan competency or under competency basically merit nipunata basically it is the degree of performance it is the degree of job performance how well how far the particular employee has worked on the job that is merit it may be excellent performance may be good performance may be average performance so likewise therefore please try to understand seniority you know defining seniority is certain but defining merit is not certain so under merit various aspects several aspects you know can be included even qualifications also we can include under merit whether the person has a degree or postgraduate degree so likewise merit right now which criterion should you use seniority or promotion seniority or merit you know because seniority or merit some organizations they use seniority only seniority when giving promotions there are some organizations which use only merit when giving promotions when giving promotions right I got a response that is merit from one student okay good merit we can give promotions based on merit right because of lack of time ekata kaale nathi nisa I will tell you the ideal answer both we have to consider the best practice is both we have to consider when we give promotion both we have to consider yes correct both seniority and merit both criteria we have to consider now the question is why both because each has advantages and disadvantages each has advantages and disadvantages. Right. You must be able to, you know, think, write down three advantages of seniority, three disadvantages of seniority, three advantages of merit, three disadvantages of merit. Can you do that? You must be able to do that. You do it yourself. Right. Now, let me show you some advantages of seniority. Some advantages of seniority. First one, it is an objective means of differentiating one employee from other employees. Ekena vishayamoolika karana. Ekena vishayamoolika nirnayakarana. Objective adding. Merit is subjective while seniority is object. Criterion itself, you know, the criterion of seniority itself does differentiating employees, not by the management. Ekena kalamanakarithwe kalamanakarithwe avashya wenna. Seniority kanu pudgalin wenas pada salaka. Meya thama weda palawiniya meya deweniya meya thungeniya seniority kanu. Eka kiyanna kawurath thonna clerk kenekunak karanna puluwan. Even a clerk can do that. You know, if there is right information, based on right information, it is possible to do that. Ayathaneta join nunu dawasa balan. Organization seniority ekak balanna. Thor department ekata aapu dawasa balan. Department seniority. It was a merit seniority. Samara Vishidyalo Vagaval, product seniority merit Tirnevanakare, Venas, you know. In universities, you know, they're determining seniority, determining the merit, you know, normally they are unique, they are different from normal business organizations. Normal business organizations. Right. All right. Okay, there is a question, you know. Some organizations give promotions taking exams like banking exam. So does this come under formal criteria? Competency? Right. Okay. It comes under merit. It comes under merit. Okay, because the merit, you know, the knowledge, skills, competence, you know, under merit, we can consider knowledge, skills, attitudes, and which can be determined by conducting an exam also by doing performance evaluation. That's why, right. Then it is certain. Measuring counting is easy. It is not biased. Seniority is not biased. It's not subject to managerial judgment and favoritism of evaluation. You know, better thing is give the promotion based on senior. But anyway, seniority matha patkirimat bayanaka. Bayanaka vendable. It may be dangerous. If you give the promotion exclusively based on seniority, that may make mukadda that it matches with our culture. Eka therena. Can you understand that? Da ape culture eke therenawane value ekak validity salakim treating others is a value of our culture. So therefore it matches with this value. Seniority. Also, seniority means what? Longer service. Longer service is dedication of the employee to the organization. You call it kidna kina ayatanita up mang then. Again, kisima vedak bari, vinatta samanya kine, you call it kinne kai, ativisista kine, you call it kinne kai deka. The ativisista kine, you call it kinne kine, kata yanda onataran ten tiendu. Onataran neta, yamprabani ka tiendu. That's real dedication to the organization. You know, if there is an employee who is an unmatched person, you know, very productive, very efficient, very effective, that person definitely has several places to go. But if that person, you know, did not decide to leave the organization and decided to stay with the organization for many years, that is longer service, which is dedication of that employee to the organization, which we have to appreciate, we have to admire. Then as a gift, you know, we can give a promotion. Right. Trade unions, I will do a separate lecture on trade unions, labor relations. Unions often prefer seniority. You know, too many. Now, kachal goda kathila thi na langkawi to promotion thi samati. Unions la kachal dala. So, they go like amati na merit, merit take it up. Because it is difficult to understand merit, it is difficult to measure merit, it is difficult to quantify merit. So therefore, bias, prejudices may occur. So therefore, trade union people, they like, they prefer, varakamati, seniority, to merit. Right. Disadvantage. Pradhana disadvantage. What is that? Can you understand? The question of whether the most senior person is the most competent person to do the job. Now that question arises. Is the senior person the most competent person to do the job? Now that's a question. That question arises. You know, the answer then, he may be, he may not be. Or she may be, she may not be. The oldest is not always the ablest. The oldest is not always the ablest. Again, why is him Vedimakena? Akiyavim Vedimakena? Vasayin Hamavitama Vendine? They may Venda Kulan, they may be, they might. Okay, so there may be employees who are more competent and better than the person with the longest service, I may trust, you know, in terms of productivity. Younger mechanic in the blind, what I wear in the top, youngest, not that young. New and younger employees are not often not motivated to improve their job quality. You know, when we give promotions based on seniority. Now, when employees get qualified for better jobs automatically by accumulating seniority. Automatically, can automatically seniority and promotion. And that kunam paling promotion. Kunam tungini. You know, the first promotion can be given when the employee has 5 years. Then second promotion can be given when the employee has 10 years. Their promotion can be given when the employee has 15 years. The aim of new and young employees, what will happen? New and young employees are often not motivated to improve their job performance. I think, you go under Indivino and senior, Nanakama in Indivino, you go under Nanakama promotion Naki. Someone in general promotion opportunities are limited. Promotion avastava limited, Sigma side. Samara, the Nakatama quasi promotions, Kajapia, then of Kotome, or Dindabu. They can very visitor among with an Amepati, they were going to talk about name. You know, that's something called quasi promotion. You know, we can introduce quasi promotions to almost all the employees in order to, you know, increase the promotion opportunities. But for under this class purpose, you know, I'm not going to detail quasi promotions. Right. Turnover of younger but more productive employees increases more likely. The Emunama young guy, I think, last and promoted very well. Hare? Any Bayanakami. Employees may get promoted to the level of their incompetence. The level of incompetence, inventable. Incompetence. The level of incompetence. Like you know, Peter Principle Kila Kila. Peter Principle Kila Kila. Make a bayana. Peter Principle Kila Kila. Because people rise to their level of incompetence. ඒ වගේ උදාහරණ දැන් උඩතර ලංකාවේ තියෙනවනේ. ගොඩක් හොයලා බලන්න වට පිට ඒකෝට තියෙනවා. හැකියාව නැති මිනිස්සු අන්තිමට නැගලා නැගලා උසස් වීම සීනියොරිටි එක නිසා එල් ටී එල් එක ගිහලා අන්තිමට කරන්න බැරි වැඩේට ප්‍රොමෝට් වෙනවා. You know, if we give a promotion to an employee to a job for which really the employee is not qualified, cannot do, that is a dangerous thing. Okay, right. Then merit එක ගත්තොත් එහෙම the value of worth of an employee for organization's success and progress of success. And ඒ විදිහට define කරන්න ඕනේ. කියන්නේ සංවිධානයේ සාර්ථකත්වයට, සාර්ථකත්වයේ ප්‍රගතියට සේවාදායකයාගේ තියෙන වටිනාකම. ඒක තමයි merit කියලා කියන්නේ. නිපුණතාව. දැන් මේ promotions වල කියන්නේ seniority කේ වාසි අරකේ අවාසි වේ. seniority කේ අවාසි මේකේ වාසි merit එක. හරි. එසා මෙන්න මේ වගේ ඒවා. more competent people can be appointed to positions for which promotions are given. ඒතොර එන්න මොකක්ද productivity will improve. ඒතොර employees who are young people, you know, they become more motivated to work successfully with the hope that they will be promoted. Okay, right. Then qualifications mata promotions denagota merit yatade, you know, they will learn, they have to learn more. Then that learning will be used for innovation, for creativity and innovation. Right, younger employees, ekolage turnover ekak adu. You know, young, you know, it can the use of merit will reduce turnover of young employees. More productive young employees, eh? Samara young ay inda puluwan, there may be young employees who are not that productive. Anyway, disadvantages, tama relatively merit is not certain, may be biased, there is no foolproof method of judging the merit. The performance appraisal like onda nattan onna prashne, if the performance appraisal is not a good one, then calculative merit becomes, you know, biased, incorrect, not appropriate. So likewise, the unions wage at meva dakmeti unions. Okay, all right. Okay, this one, problems arising from promotions, no need, there may be some problem, but no need for this classroom purpose, right? Okay, now let us go to next one, next type of employee movements, transfers. So what is a transfer? Transfer is the moving of an employee within the same job, within the same class, within the same grade. Okay, right. You are game pulling, you know, from one job to another job within the same class or grade, from one place to another place. You can abhi tumko assistant commissioner health then in the job ek one job, you know, can be transferred to assistant commissioner Buddhist affairs. Now, that's an example. Then from one place to another place, from marketing to sales, one place to all, from office to factory, then from one time to another time. Okay, day night ekak api thama day dawal shift ekak, from day shift to night shift, one time to another time, then from office to field. Yes, මේක from one place to another place, මේක office to field දේ නා, from field to office වෙන්නත් පුළුවන, that is possible. Then from one place to another place, from Anuradhapura to Mathali, or from Colombo to Mathali, one place to another place, geographical place. Okay, so then within the same class, from one job to another. So likewise, the change of employment of the employee we can identify as a transfer. Okay, it is not an upward move. It is not an upward movement. It is a horizontal movement. You know, it is not a vertical movement, vertical up movement. Again, sirasso udara sidu wenna movement ekak nenne. That is a promotion. The meka tirasso wen horizontal. If you think of the organizational chart, the organizational structure ekak gatta. Right. Are transfers necessary? Maruhim atyavashya. Generally, you know, transfers can be done in an organization. However, transfers are not essential, not indispensable, not necessary. Transfers must not be done on an imitation basis, but on the needs of the organization. Can you understand this? එකන අනුකරණ පදනමක් මත මාරු කිරීම සිදු නොකළ යුතුය. එසේ කළ යුත්තේ ආයතනයේ අවශ්‍යතාවය මතයි. ඒ නිසා මාරු කිරීම අත්‍යවශ්‍යම අත්‍යවශ්‍ය නැහැ. අනිවාර්යව කරන්න ඕනේ නැහැ. යෝග්‍ය නම් සුදුසු නම් පමණක් කළ යුතුය. එකනේ HRM theory එකේ මාරු කිරීම ගැන කතා කරන ඉන්න කරන්නේ. අනිකුත් ආයතන මාරු කිරීම කරන ඉන්න කරන්න ඕනේ මේක. You know, in the theory of HRM, we discuss transfers, management of transfers. Therefore, we should do transfers. No, we should not do that. If there is no real business need, sabab vyapar avashyathawa naththam karanna one. Because other organizations are doing transfers, we should do transfers. No, we should not do. Because there's a major disadvantage of giving transfers. What is that? That is, transfers do discourage specialization. Can visheshikarane kiyanne eka discourage karana transfers. Now encourage karana specialization. Thora samare wata visheshikarane athyawashya. Dan oy api thama koya heart disease athakota oy corona disease arawa mewa owa kata e wagema HR noyuk ekena technical skills schemes develop කරන්න ඕන වෙනකොට එතකොට financial schemes මොනවයිකුත් ඒවා develop කරන්න ඕන වෙනකොට we need a specialization. You know that, you know, specialization is essential, especially, you know, for developing HRM schemes, financial schemes, management schemes, you know, solutions for various diseases. The experts අවශ්‍යයි. දොර transfers කරන්න කිව්වොත් එම අපි හිතමු කො ළමා රෝග අංශයේ වැඩ කරපු එක්කෙනෙක් අවුරුද්දයක් ගියට පස්සේ වෙන අංශයකට. වෙන අංශයකට. වැඩි හිටියන් අංශය. ඒකෙන් තව තැනකට දාන්න. ඔහොමම කිච්චර හොඳ නැහැ. මොකද විශේෂ we do need experts source. We do need generalist source. සාමාන්‍ය ඇත් අවශ්‍යයි. يعني ගොඩාක් එකක් ගැන දන්න නෙමෙයි ටික ටික ගොඩක් දේවල් ගැන දන්න. You know, we need generalist also. A generalist is a person who know many things, but not in a deep way. Encourage, all right. Encourage what, sir? Okay, special, you know, generalization. Transfers, encourage, generalization. Generalization can visheshikaran. Generalization. Specialization. Specialization neka encourage karanne. Aneka yethi ena ekena vishesh e wage ma ආයතනෙ පිරිවැය වැඩි වෙනවා කස්ටමර්ස් ලාන්න හැපි වෙන්නත් පුළුවන්. දැන් එක එක මාසෙන් මාසෙට එක එක සේවකයෝ ඉන්නකොට එහෙම කස්ටමර්ස් ලා දෙපාරයි. විශේෂයෙන් I'm talking about sales people. I'm talking about employees who directly deal with external customers. If you have, you know, if you do transfers frequently, then customers will not experience same people, familiar people. They may not be, they are not happy about that. They want to see familiar people. ekena hondata aachara karana danna ඒ සේවාදායක අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා කස්ටමර්ස් ආයතනත් ප්‍රශ්නයක් වෙනවා ඒක ඒ කියන්නේ from the point of customer satisfaction customer satisfaction එක පැත්තෙන් ප්‍රශ්නයක් එන්න පුළුවන් it's possible satisfaction okay all right අද මොනවාද දැන් මේ ව්‍යාපාර අවශ්‍යතා can what are the genuine business needs which will necessitate transfers transfers avashya ben sabha vyapara avashyata monawa ilagada katha karana den ewa danaganna so I'm going to talk about types of transfers from each type you will be able to understand one genuine business reason Right. What are the types of transfers? Productive transfers. Again, we're going to have nishpadak transfers. Again, productive transfers. Policy-oriented transfers. Pratipatti moolika transfers. Disciplinary transfers. Vinaya sambandha transfers. Remedial corrective transfers. Nirvadhya marukiri. Vacant transfers. Abhyartha marukiri. Shift transfers. වැඩමුර මාරුකිරි versatility transfers මෙතන versatility කියලා කියන්නේ විවිධ හැකියා බහු හැකියා මාරුකිරි versatility then interest oriented transfers රුචිය මූලික කරගත් transfers problem oriented transfers රුචි නැබුරු transfers මේක problem oriented transfers Gatalu Naburu transfers. These are certain types of transfers. That may have a type pick a kim genuine business reason. Every type of transfers gives a genuine business need, which will necessitate doing transfers. Doing transfers. Adan ekka gana podda balam. Productive transfers. When an organization has a department or section where there's a surplus of employees and a department or section as well where there is a shortage of employees productive transfers can be done can you understand okay in our organization assume in the factory there is a shortage of production employees in the administration department there's a surplus of employees the drivers එකන ඩ්‍රයිවර්ස් ලාගේ අතිරික්තයක් තියෙනවා ඇඩ්මිනිස්ට්‍රේෂන් ඩිපාර්ට්මන්ට් එකේ. ෆැක්ටරි එකේ ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් ඩිපාර්ට්මන්ට් එක අපි හිතමු ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් එම්ප්ලොයිස් ලාගේ හිඟයක් තියෙනවා සර්ප්ලස්. ආදැම් මේ ඩ්‍රයිවර්ස් ලා අස් කරන්නත් පුළුවන්. ඩ්‍රයිවර්ස් ලා අස් කරන්න නැතුව මාරු කරන්න පුළුවන් ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් සෙක්ෂන්. ඒගොල්ල කැමති වෙන්නත් ඕනේ ඒගොල්ලන්ට මේ වැඩ ඒ පිළිබඳව වැඩ කරන්න හැකියාව තියෙනත් ඕන. ඕකේ. So then assume there are three drivers who are in excess. These three drivers assume can work as production supervisors sorry production employees also they like to work as production supervisors sorry production employees not production supervisors production employees right so they like to work they are capable then they can be transferred from administration section to production section that those transfers are called productive transfers hari ema atirikta tiyana avasthawaka sewako uwat karannatu as karannatu marukirimak karana nam wenath ekakata etana ekata kiyanne productive transfers like yana apubi productive kiyana wacana yawilla thiyenne because of this transfers we can maintain productive we can improve productive then policy oriented transfers pratipathyak mata මාරු කරන්න පුළුවන්. දැන් විශේෂයෙන් රාජ්‍ය ආයතනවල එහෙම කරනවා. බැංකුවලත් එහෙම තියෙනවා. එකම බ්‍රාන්ච් එකේ අවුරුදු ගාණක් ඉඳ දෙන්නේ නැහැ. එතකොට හොරකම් සිද්ධ වෙන්න පුළුවන්, තව නිකුත් දේවල් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. Right? So in order to avoid stealing bad things, certain organizations they don't want to keep the employee for many years within the same department. Or within the same branch Then those organizations can have a policy of transferring employees for every 5 years. හැම අවුරුද්දකම අවුරුදු පහකටම පස්සේ මාරු කරන්න පුළුවන්. The විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයක උනක් තියෙනයි. In a university also we can see that. The school වලක් තියෙන අවුරුදු 10න් 10ට මට මතකයි තේරු මාධ්‍යම ප්‍රවාසයේ ඉන්න කාලේ. When I was in Sri Lanka Education Administrative Service, I could remember there was a government policy to transfer teachers for every 10 years. You know, ekam school, you know, a teacher cannot work more than 10 years in one school. Thinda ngowa wenas karanne gihilla noyikut prashna thiyen. Health sector ekata ehema thamai dostarla sambandha. Thinda ewa gana katha karanna dan wela ne. Ewa cases, critical incidents. Right. So therefore, as a policy, then Tawaika, Sri Lanka Army can just take Sri Lanka Army. The Army ki Islam appointment they know, right? The soldier ki ne kiri vare karande. Then wo agi avastha agne ekhali thi puna. You know, when we were having war, you know, there was a transfer policy for, you know, if, you know, valid for private soldiers. Every soldier, you know, had to work for at least 6 months in an operation area, in a war area. And after that, the person will become eligible to get a transfer. So, if you're eligible, eligibility doesn't guarantee giving a transfer. There should be, you know, transfer opportunities. Then disciplinary oriented transfer. As a punishment, you know, as a punishment, we can transfer. We can give a transfer to an employee. That is called disciplinary oriented transfer. The remedial transfer. Where are the quilla? Where the kinek yamkisi department take it out? Yeah, when you were the current winner, department take it out. That on the veteran pull. Then in the veteran bank. Assume there is an employee, you know, who cannot perform the duties successfully in the current department. But the employee can work, you know, can do a good job in another department. Then we can give a transfer to that employee. You know, to correct a wrongful decision. Vacant transfers, when there's a vacancy, assume, you know, we are in a bank, in the Anuradhapura branch, there's a vacancy. For the post of managing job, you know, bank manager, then we can give a transfer. We can give a promotion with the transfer, you know, to a manager, you know, to a person who is currently working as the assistant manager in Colombo. They can samalada promotion ne kai transfer kai dekha mikar din na. We can give a promotion with the transfer. Then shift transfer. You know, from day shift to night shift, from morning shift to night shift. Versatility transfers. Then bausruta bhavi. Vedi, we can godak deval danaganna avashyana. Godak deval danaganeemata seva daayaka walak karanna avashyana. We can give versatility transfers. You know, from one job to another job, job rotation. You have learned job rotation. And then the employee will be able to perform different jobs. And because of that, there are advantages for the employee, also for the organization. So can you please show the slide of disciplinary transfers again? Disciplinary oriented transfer, okay? As a response to a request made by a student, right? Versatility transfers, then interest oriented transfers. transfer that is given on a real need of an employer is called an interest oriented trust. Davido meme, there is a female employee in a bank, you know, who got married recently. Then, you know, she's in Colombo, but her husband is in Anuradhapura. She wants to have a work family balance. So then, you know, she has requested for a transfer from Colombo to Anuradhapura. Then that is because of interest of the employee, we can give a transfer. The organization can give a transfer to that employee in order to motivate that employee. Or as a gift to that employee. That is called interest-oriented transfer. Then problem-oriented transfer. Problem-oriented transfers. Then conflict there. Then you have conflict there. Then I have conflict. So there's a conflict, serious conflict between two people who are working in the same department. Then in order to maintain order, in order to maintain customer satisfaction, then we can decide to transfer one employee from this department to another one. Or both. Both can be transferred. Problem-oriented transfers. Yeah, examples are problem-oriented transfers. Policies and procedures in transfer. Samani elements kela gera. Elements of transfers. Then may policies, procedures hurried the end on in transfers. In the policies common develop karani, procedures common develop karani kenega. May panti avashyathavedi katakarani. May panti radalo katakarani. How to develop policies, how to develop procedures in specific relating to transfers, you know, that is beyond the objectives of this class. But anyway, certain things, you know, that you should know. Jobs for that, the transfer should be made, should be specified. You can monowage job sort of transfer, then specify grammar. Departments, areas, fields which within which transfers are made should be specified. Monomono department atre, field atre, areas atre, transfers yanne kela, nischitha vasin sadhan karaganna one. Circumstances or reasons under which transfers are made. Hetu, transfers, orata hetu monada, e mata, e hetu mata, menna meva mata transfers karunai kela, sadhan karanna one. Then policies, procedures should be in writing. You know, those things should be in writing. And inform to every employee. I'm a kid from then on the note. You know, for good management of transfers. For good management of transfers. Right. Then now layoff. Layoff kill again, Navathali. Single in Kenamagata? Navathalim. Is second at Unam and Navathalim. You know, if you delete S, then it will be a singular one, layoff. Right. What is a layoff? It is a temporary stoppage of the employee. Can seva niyuktiya tavakaliko natara kirim. Sevakekge seva niyuktiya tavakaliko natara kirim. Okay, so under this, the organization does stopping temporarily the job of an employee. Why? Due to a reason or reasons which are generally not controllable by the management of the organization. Again, Sangudane Kalamana Karate, Saman Palnekar and Berry, Hetuako, Hetunisatamai, Kavakaliko Natan, Save. I can lay off here. I make asking even me. This is not termination. This is not dismission. Dismission can I put him. Then dismission even me. Dismission even me. Okay, this is there is something called dismission. It's not dismission. also it's not termination. It's not termination. But termination එකක් වෙන්න තියනවා. There is a kind of termination, but which is a temporary one. Temporary one. Not permanent one. Not permanent one. Okay? Right. Reasons for layoff. The layoff නැත්නම් S එකක් විතර එන්න ඕනේ. One reason මෙන්න මේකයි. Seasonal fluctuations. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් එක එක කාලවලට සිදුවන උච්චාවච. මොකක් සම්බන්ධයෙන්ද? නිෂ්පාදනයට අදාළ ඉල්ලුම. ඒ කියන්නේ බාණ්ඩ වලට අදාළ ඉල්ලුම උච්චාවචන වෙන ඒවා තියෙනවා. අන්න ඒ හේතුව මත මේ layoff සිද්ධ කරන්න පුළුවන්. දැන් උදාහරණයක් ඇටියට then printing industry printing you know let us take printing industry you know our organization you know is engaging in printing industry you know normally there is a good time or peak time kila gena peak time also there's a weak time down time illuma wedi kalayak dena illuma adu kalayak normally when there are functions you know when there are Christmas and you know new year and all the functions and then there's a high demand for printing. Also school timing, you know, school in you know school starting the eva ge deval you know there is a high demand for printing industry, but there is a low demand time also. And then sancharika vyapara tourism industry, the sancharika wediyen mena kalayak tiya, you know, there's a time that we can experience the highest number or higher number of tourists coming to Sri Lanka, coming to hotels. Also there's a weak time, down time, only few or perhaps no travelers, right? Then එතකොට demand එක වැඩි වෙනකොට සේවකයෝ වැඩි වෙනවා. Demand එක අඩු වෙනකොට සේවකයෝ අඩු වෙනවා. You know, we need a lesser number of employees when there is a lower demand for the product. When there's a higher demand, we have to increase employees. එතකොට අන්න lower time, down time එකකට we have to reduce. The main purpose එකට මොකද කරන්නේ? මොකක් ආයතන? Casual employees, temporary employees නැගා. දැන් යන්න ඒ අය තමයි නවතාලීම් කරන්නේ. එයාව නවත්තනවා. Down time එකේදී නවත්තනවා. දැන් මේක ideally you know there should be casual employees. Then during the down time, casual employees are laid off. Or some of laid off, but during the peak time then they are invited again to the organization to work. Nara aradhana karana weda karanne kiyala. Due to civil disturbances then we are not to pachal bachan ehema athi wenawa. Etakota ayathana wahanna wenawa. Then corona inda samara aya laid off karanna siddha vela thiyenna puluwan. ඒක වෙනම එකයි ඒක civil disturbances නෙමෙයි anyway due to considerable defective machines that need repairs and a damage you know machines damage වෙලා තියෙනවා so assume in order to repair machines you know it will take 2 months and then for casual employees assume there are 10 casual employees they can be laid off until we repair the machines then after repairing the machines again we can invite those 10 you know laid off employees laid off right the shortage of materials power ehemath ena materials inga una una nawattanne these things are usually not controlled you know cannot be controlled by management right then the methods of layoff නැහැ ඒ වගේ අවස්ථාවක දැන් කොහමද ලේඔෆ් කරන්නේ නවතාලන්න සිද්ධ වෙනකොට දැන් මොන පදනමක් වත් නවතාලන්න බම්පින් අබම්කින් කියන්නේ මූණ දිහා බලලා සම්බන්ධතා අනුව කිසිම පදනමක් නැතුව නැත්නම් පදනම් තියෙනවා පිළිගන්න බැරි පදනම් මත සේවකාස් කරනවා ඔයා එන්න එපා ඔයා එන්න කියලා අන්න එහෙම කියනවා ආබිට්‍රලි you know we do laying off this is not recommended this is not recommended LIFO, FIFO, agent method, formal method. At least there are 5 methods. okay, bumping can and never. This is not good, this is not recommended. Looking at faces based on sympathy, based on relationships, personal relationships, employees can be laid off. This is not good, this is not recommended. The life, last in first half. Last in first half. Then you give a costing all of the matter and costing one last in first half. Stand for last in first half. So it means doing first layoff of the employee who had been hired last. Antimata bath that take in. Say, okay, the other thing. Assume there are 10 casual employees or temporary employees. You know, today we have to lay off one employee. Out of 10 employees, then who is going to be laid off? We have to decide. If we follow LIFO method, then the employee who joined last is going to be laid off. Are you going to be laid off? 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 The first person came, 6 months later. That person is going to be laid off as the last person. Advantage, one big advantage. More experienced people we can keep. Then more familiar people, employees who are familiar to customers we can keep. Are there advantages? But there's a big disadvantage. This is against the principles of parity. A parity kila mula dharma yati. Ikan samanatata mula dharma. Aikata patani. Ikan api samanatata ave. Ikan hama otama iting jivate no sarla na vidiyete. Api itama jobs guda permanent job din the back. Tore casual job, temporary job stama din the pulwa. Ikan hama otama avastavak samana. Avruddhako avruddhyakko vedakan pulwa vidiyete. Jobs then known, avastha then known, parity given. What do you mean by parity principle? You know, giving an equal chance of working to everyone. Now the method antimata gatte kina vatkana with the equal chance at me. Adum medical pekina tama yvatka. You know, if we decide to lay off the employee who had been hired last, I think that person is the person who got the least chance of working, least opportunity of working, the minimum. What to do? Right. Then the 5-1 principle required, FIFO method is in line with principles of parity. But it is against what? Against the productivity, counterproductive. By assumption, you know, more experienced people are more productive. They have been at the end of the world. Can I be good experience the night? Good up productive. Paladai Kilakinabi. Generally, we make an assumption like this. They have no end up. Right, anyway, five. First in first time. Islam Abik. Assume there are two employees. One joined 2 months ago. The other person joined 1 month ago. Then we have to lay off one person. Then the first person who joined 2 months ago, we decide to lay off. Right. Then the agent method. American outsourcing. You know, we take people, from an agent, an employment agent. Then it is the duty of the employment agent to provide employees, also to lay off employees. Then it is not a work of the particular organization which uses such employees. If a gas to given agent method, the make up Monday, Amara Ayatana, Vedak specialized in Ayatana Dinan and the agents, if they are highly specialized in HRM and all this, so then, better employees can be obtained. Also, the fee, then Tamamakaranatada, Vasi Vendapur. If we maintain a temporary staff or casual staff, then we have to hire, we have to do a lot of HR things. Like a cost takai, fitting garnek a cost takai. Isiam gas to a dealer, minister, save it a garnekai. Apima, या वैरकने या वो पालने के लिए विचार करने को दर ला करने का ही नहीं के कॉस्ट एंड बेनिफिट्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट इफ बेनिफिट्स यू नो एक्सीड कॉस्ट देन डेफिनेटली वी कैन डिसाइड टू यूज एजेंट मेथड देन द फॉर्मल मेथड यू नो दीज मेथड्स आउट ऑफ दीज मेथड्स बम्पिंग लाइफो फाइफो एजेंट मेथड फॉर्मल मेथड द बेस्ट वन इज फॉर्मल मेथड बट दैट इज द मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव because it takes a lot of time, a lot of effort. It requires, an expertise of HR. If it is available, then no problem. If it is not available within the organization, then this cannot be utilized. You can formal method, we develop a good scheme, formal scheme, written scheme. By considering various things, you know, we develop objectives, we develop policy, we develop procedure. We can consider merit, we can consider seniority, we can consider qualifications. All these things, you know, we can consider age. Formal method. Right. Okay, any questions? Up to now. Right. In some way, layoff, samani, permanent employees will make a dal and other they are. Layoff are not relevant to permanent employees. One question එකක් තියෙනවා මොකද්ද? අම්මෝ questions ගොඩක් එනවා වගේ. Bumping please. All right. Then should the entity pay a salary for employees? All right. Okay, good, good. Should they, you know, should we give a salary to laid off employees? No, we should not. But some companies, very good companies, they can give maybe a certain percentage of salary, you know, as an incentive to come back. Again, we have an intention of taking the person back when we have the right time. Then we want to make sure that when we invite, the relevant person should be there to come to our work. Then as an incentive, you know, we can give 1/3 of the salary. But after report, otherwise the person will take the money and will not come. But generally, organization don't do paying, to laid off employees, especially during this corona time and all this. You know, they really want to, organizations want to, you know, cut the cost. Right. Then another request. Bumping one. Okay, this slide. Slide of policies proceedings. Okay, all right. Okay, this one, policies and procedures. Right. Okay, then. There are some other employee movements. What are they? These are, other types of employee movements. Demotions, dismissals, terminations, retrenchment, retirements. But they are not supposed to learn for this class. But just to know, demotion can pull out that. The opposite of the promotion. Dismissal can kelimaskala nirapala that. You know, normally on disciplinary ground, we, you know, terminate the person because the person has done a bad thing, very bad thing to the organization. Right. Then retrenchment kiyala kiyanne ඇත්තම ආයතනයේ රස්සාවක් දෙන්න විදියක් නෑ. You know, due to maybe due to a clause of a business or branch. Now, you know, 10 employees, you know, cannot be employed further. They will have to be terminated permanently. Under laid off, you know, laying off, under laying off, there is an intention of taking the person back. While under retrenchment, there's no intention of taking the person back. Retirement කියන එක දන්නවනේ විස්රාමය. You know, after you know reaching the retirement age, right? Okay, then dear students, I think this is enough. I have to participate in the convocation ceremony also. Last slide now. This one, retirement. Okay, then, dear students, please take care. Right. Okay, then, see you next week.